Welcome to this Flutter Slider tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to customize the thumb and divider in Syncfusion's Flutter Slider widget. I'm using an example application that was configured with the slider widget and an initial value. To learn how to integrate the slider widget into a Flutter application, please check out the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application in an Android emulator. You can see the slider with the default value. Next, I'll show you how to customize the divider. In the pub/spec YAML file, import the Syncfusion Flutter core package to customize the slider theme. Import the theme package into the main package. Wrap the slider with the slider theme. Set its data property to slider theme data. Set active and inactive track heights to 18, so that you can see a wider track in the slider. To change the color of the track, define a color field so that you can use it in the theme. In the slider theme data, set the active track color with a field value with opacity. Similarly, set the inactive track color with a field value with different opacity. Now you can see the slider track with a different size and color. When I drag the thumb, you can see the active and inactive track colors are customized. Now let's customize the dividers in the slider track. I will create a diamond shape instead of the default circle dividers. Create a divider shape class that extends the SF divider shape. Declare a color variable and use it to receive the active color from the constrictor. Override the paint method and remove the super class calling statement since I am going to customize the painting. Define a path variable to draw the diamond shape. Use the context and canvas properties to draw the inner path. Set the paint's color to the active color and style to fill so that the diamond shape will be a solid color. In the slider widget, set the divider shape property with a custom divider shape class by passing the active color as an argument. Now you can see the dividers are a diamond shape. I can also customize each divider color based on its position relative to the slider thumb. Let's change the inactive diamonds to white. To do this, I need to check whether the current position is active or inactive. So, in the paint method, declare a Boolean variable to store the active status. Use a switch statement to check that the text direction is left to right and set the isActive property. It is true when the center is less than or equal to the thumb center. This condition is applicable for languages like English and French. In the case of right to left text, for languages like Arabic and Hebrew, the isActive property should be true when the center is greater than the thumb center. In the color property, use the isActive property to set the active color and set white for the inactive color. Now you can see the dividers are in white for the inactive part. Even when I slide the thumb, the active and inactive parts are rendered as expected. Next, let me customize the thumb shape with a directional arrow that changes direction based on the slider movement. First, create a thumb shape class that inherits from the SF thumb shape. Declare fields to store the active color and active state as a Boolean type. Create a constrictor to receive those values as parameters. Override the paint method. Then, use the context and canvas properties to draw circles. Pass the center radius as 25, and in the paint argument, pass the value with the active color and the fill style property. This will create a circle shape for the thumb. Define a field to store the right arrow path. Similarly, define the left arrow path field. Draw the path of the left and right arrows based on the active Boolean property. Pass the color as white, style as fill, and stroke width as 2. In the slider widget, set the thumb shape property with the newly created class by passing the active color and active property. Create a member variable for this active field and set its default value to false. In the slider widget's onChanged function, if the new value is less than the slider value, then set the active property to true. Otherwise, it's false. This allows drawing left or right arrow marks in the thumb shape class. In the SF slider theme data class, set the overlay color property with the active color, changing the opacity. Set the overlay radius with the value 35. This will give an overlay effect while using the thumb in the slider. Now you can see the overlay effect in the thumb. While sliding to the right, the arrow mark's direction changes. The left arrow mark is shown while sliding left. Now you can instantly know the slider's direction, improving the UI's intuitiveness. Let's see how the same code works in a web browser. Stop the application, change the device name to Chrome, and run the application. You can see the slider widget with the customization. I can use the slider, and the active and inactive slide dividers are painted as expected. Finally, let me show you how this works on the desktop. Change the device to Windows and run the application. The slider has the custom UI, and it works as expected. To summarize this video, I have shown you how to customize the thumb and divider in the Syncfusion Flutter Slider widget. You can download the example used in this video from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you're eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Flutter product suite. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.